one morning at 2 o'clock in the afternoon, knocked up yet a customer, who as a customer is going to run a flower shop on Skid Row.
I'm sorry.
Seymour, what's going on back there?
Very little, Mr. Bushnick.
Audrey, you better come back and see me. Audrey, where'd you get that shiner?
Shiner?
That greasy boyfriend of yours, he's beating up on you again? Look, I know it's none of my business, but I'm beginning to think he's maybe not such a nice boy.
You don't meet nice boys when you live on Skid Row, Mr. Bushnick.
I got these plantery potters.
Seymour, look what you've done with the inventory.
Don't you let Seymour, Mr. Bushnick?
Oh, hi, Audrey. You look radiant today. Is that a new eye makeup?
I'll clean it up before any of the customers get here.
That'll give you plenty of time. Look, God, what an existence I got. Misfit employees, focus on the skyline. And this is a house. My life is a living 6 o'clock and we didn't sell so much paper. I guess this is it. Don't bother coming in tomorrow.
You don't mean?
You can mean.
What don't I mean? I mean I'm closed for day. Kaput.
You can't!
Kaput extinct. I'm closing this goddamn customer forsaken place.
Mr. Mushnik, forgive me for saying so, but hasn't it ever occurred to you that maybe what the firm needs is to move in a new direction?
Exotic little beauty did for our business.
I know.
So work, Seymour. Nurse that plant.
sunshine. I've given you dirt. You've given me nothing. Yeah.
Seymour, did you send out the order for Mrs. Shiva?
Mrs. Shiva? Right. I forgot.
God, how could you forget an order like that? The Shivas are a most important funeral account. A big, enormous family, and they're dropping off like flies. I'm telling you, Crowborn, if we lose their business over this, you are finished!
You know, sometimes I think Mr. Mushnick's too hard on you.
Oh, I don't mind. After all, I owe him everything. He took me out of the sweet girl home for boys when I was just a little tyke. And gave me a nice place to sleep under the counter. Nice things to eat, like meatloaf and water. Floors to sweep and toilets to clean and every other Sunday off.
You know, I think you ought to raise your expectations, Seymour. Now that you're getting successful, I mean, why don't you start with some new clothes? No offense, but with all the interviews and photo sessions, a big, important experimental botanist has to look the part.
Well, I'm a very bad shopper, Audrey. I don't have good taste, like you.
Well, I could have you pick things out.
You could?
Sure.
You'd go shopping with me?
Sure.
You'd be seen with me in a public place, like a department store?
Sure.
Well, tonight?
Oh, I can't tonight. I've got a date. But I'd like to go with you another time.
Oh, sure. Sure, I'll pencil you in.
I bet you got a lot of dates now, huh?
Not dates exactly, but a lot of garden clubs have been calling, asking me to give lectures.
Gee!
Imagine me, giving lectures. I never even finished grade school.
That doesn't matter. You've got life experience.
Some experience. I don't even know what it's like to fly in an airplane.
Well, me neither.
Or eat a fancy dinner at Howard Johnson's.
Me neither.
Or ride a motorcycle.
It's no big deal. Besides, it's dangerous.
It is?
Extremely dangerous. Well, I better go fix my face. My date will be here any minute.
She said, my boy, I've been some pain.
I'm not trying to shop back here. Hey, that was me, the plan, and talking about it in the news. What do you call it?
And Audrey, too.
She's painful. Catchy. Nice plan. Hey.
Thank you. I raised it myself. Now, if you don't mind, I'm not really supposed to let anybody.
It's okay, Seymour. This is my boyfriend. Seymour? Or it's her fellow, DDS.
Let me tell you something, kid. You raised this thing, right?
Right.
Well, if I were you, I sure as hell wouldn't get down in her barrel and some skin or gun like this. This avocado here could be your ticket to the stars. You can take me to any floor shop in town and name your price. Heck, somebody would make you a goddamn partner to get their hands on this.
Well, I don't care. I'm happy here.
Seymour's very loyal.
So can I talk to you?
Oh, no.
What?
Excuse me, doctor.
That's better. I'm telling you, kid, this thing's a big, green gold mine. Get your ass out of this dump and take the plant with you.
What?
You must think Skid Row floors? It's like a joke. You hear me talking?
Sure, I hear you.
She hears him.
Shouldn't we be leaving now? I'm sorry.
Sorry what?
Sorry, doctor. Doctor, sorry, doctor.
You got a train, amazing. Well, my bike's outside and double parked. Would you think about what I said, Scout? I mean it. You think about it.
Sure. I'll think about it.
You'll think about it?
You do that. Okay, I get it. You got the handcuffs.
They're right here in my bag.
Let's go.
She'll think about it. She'll think about it.
My son.
six taking a junior. And someday when I own this whole shop, I'll remember I owe it to you. Who cares if I've been a little on the anemic side these past few weeks? So what if I had a few dizzy spells? A little lightheadedness? It's been worth it, old pal. Well, Timmy, I'm a little hungry. I gotta run down to Symmetrics and get you a bite to eat. I'll see you in the morning. Oh boy, not again. Look, I haven't got much left, okay? Just give me a few more days to heal and then we'll start getting on my left.
Me!
I beg your pardon?
Feet now!
But I can't!
think I need a root canal. I'm sure I need a long, slow root canal.
Let's go.
I have a history of dental problems.
Shut up.
Yes, doctor. I went to a terrible dentist on Wednesday who was recommended to me by a man that I see on Sundays, who's actually the brother man that I see on Mondays, and the mother taught them everything they know. She's quite elderly. Most people say she shouldn't be working, but I work because I'm just so incredibly devoted to her strength. She can't really see me wherever she goes. She knows from the sound of the voice that we tell her where it is, the problem. She lets you work from her back, she finds that she doesn't. I wish I had that stamina. Because I can't live so long. That's how I want it to be. I never wanted to be just a
helping.
Yes, doctor. I remember the first time I went to the dentist and thought, God, what a neat job. If only I were a dentist. The dentist I had the coolest car. He had a Corvette. I thought, God, when he goes to the doctor, but he's not really a doctor. Oh my God! I got out of the room, okay. But afterwards, they gave me a candy bar. I thought, this is what I get. I go through all this, and they gave me a candy bar. It's worked with incredibly gifted professionals. Worked with incredibly blessed.
Well, Seymour, I don't think you understand. Don't.
Audrey,
you should
that lovesickly with you. Show me your face, as clean as the morning. I know things were bad, but now they're okay. Suddenly Seymour is standing beside you. You don't need no makeup, don't have to pretend.
Twice. He knows just what you've done.
And the red dots seemed innocent enough.
You got no blame.
knock?
particular.
Come on, Krill Boy, feed me. I ain't had since Mushnick, and that was a week ago.
Look, just hold out one more night, can ya? That's all I ask. Life magazine will be here in the morning to take our pictures.
And then you'll find me somebody.
And then you'll never be hungry again. I promise.
Chow time, Krill Boy!
You're scaring me!
Yeah.